Hope everyone's doing well. My name is EQ. Welcome to another episode of Stonkaholics. So we're going to be going over a coin that I've been holding off on for a while, Helium Network Token. The main reason I was holding off was because I was anticipating having a couple miners here by this point, but they've been on back order because of the shortage of those chips. So in anticipation of a couple of them that are getting shipped out soon, we're going to be covering it now and going over the price predictions and a little bit what Helium Token is and talk about the miner a little bit to set up for the next video when I talk about setting up the miner and then the final wrap up a month later on how much these miners will make you in a month. So Helium's currently ranked number 76, sitting at $12. And a $1 billion market cap, currently at a circulating supply of 83.7 million, which is 38% of its total and max supply, which is a finite supply of 223 million. And finite supply meaning that there is a limited supply of coins like Bitcoin, so once it runs out and price will start to skyrocket. An easy way to explain what these Helium tokens and routers are and what makes up this amazing project is that everyone can go and have access to these routers. That you install in your house, all you need is access to internet and power and a phone, and you can connect these routers to a wallet, and when they communicate with other routers in the area, they generate money. Earlier this year and into last year, when people were first starting these routers and these hotspots, they were making around $1,000 a month. That was when the price of Helium was around $2. Now that the price of Helium is around $12, you're starting to see people make upwards of $5,000 to $7,000 in a month just off one router. So in terms of mining and anything like that, this is the most profitable miner there is at the moment without having to break your bank. Essentially how these routers work is that it works like a 4G or 5G network. So it creates a huge network. Essentially all you need are 25 of these routers in a city to cover the entire city. But the more you have in a city, the better the communication is. And these networks communicate with certain things like dog collars and stuff like that. So they have a GPS dog collar that you can track your dog pretty much in real time. And other different real time projects, for example, Lime scooters, they're using them for the recovery of the scooters and to be able to track where the scooters are so they can pick them up, recharge them, and drop them into high volume areas. The projects that are on Helium are just going to continue to grow and grow. I'm sure at some point they're going to have some contract with, you know, a major telephone company or something like that. So you see, we currently have 41,000 hotspots around the world, and if you go to the Explorer map, you'll be able to go on here and see exactly where the miners are, where the hotspots are located, what areas are good for the hotspots, which regions are great, and you can see the countdown to halving, which I've heard some things of people talking about that this date is going to get pushed because of the delay on the miners and some problems with the technology and this and that. So hopefully that does get pushed back. That means that we're going to be making more money. What the halving means is that you're going to be getting your mining rewards cut in half, but that's anticipation of the price of Helium going up more. So yeah, you're getting less token, but it's more valuable of a token, so it's going to pay out in the end. So going into the TA on HNT, you see the dip really didn't do that much to the price. It was able to hold a nice support here. You can see our last minute support down here was able to hold. We got these last wicks that touched, but nothing more than wicks. That's a good sign. Essentially, we just made this giant channel with price, and it mapped out the high of the channel as well as a potential impulse support, which is in these candle region right here. If price wanted to get to this point, we could see the impulse move out of the channel, which could take the price of Helium up to 30%, which would be our TP3, which would take price up to $30, which is our TP3. So where price is currently sitting at the bottom of the channel, just to test the all-time high, you're looking at a 75% move. Now, from where price currently is sitting all the way to TP3, you're looking at 157% move. So if it's a project that you like and Helium is something that you're into, I would definitely look into the miners, see if it's something that would be worth investing in, see if they're popular in your area, how much people are making in your general area. Put all of those things together and you could be making a lot of money and supporting a really good project that you like. That's something that I'm doing. I believe in it. I think it's something really good. I think that it can make a lot of moves and end up staying in the top 20 coins going forward into the future. It is a finite token and you're going through halving processes and you're mining it. So at a certain point, once the miners are out of the game, that's when this coin is going to be its most valuable. So if you're sitting in the long-term game, this coin could potentially be worth hundreds of dollars and you're sitting on a giant gold mine that all it really took was you plugging it into the wall and setting up with your phone, and that's it. It took no computer skills or anything crazy for you to make that money. So that's something that I would call the new wave miner. Unlike a Bitcoin or something like that, where you see these giant mining warehouses, people can set up these Helium hotspots and other IoTs that are like the hotspot. And from doing that, you can save the space, the energy, and be able to produce essentially just as much in a large space. And looking at its market cap, if it wanted to even tap on the top 50, that would be a 2x move, so $24. And then to get from a $2 billion market cap to a $20 billion market cap would be another 10x move. A $24 billion market cap wouldn't even put it in the top 10, I don't think. At just barely, you'd be sitting at the number 8 spot right now, and that's including that we're at a very low during this dip. So you're talking about price potentially getting up to $240 if Helium wanted to get to a $20 billion market cap. Don't forget, if you didn't get a chance before, subscribe to the channel, throw a like on the video if you found anything useful, and that's going to wrap up this video.